Coming on to cephalosporins. Cephalosporins are very closely related to penicillin. Mostly semi-synthetic. They have same mode of action as well as the same resistant mechanism. They are more resistant to penicillin than to certain lactamases. Now coming on to the classification, which is quite important, quite tricky. I'll tell you an easy way how to remember it. First of all, we have five generations. First generation, second generation, third generation, fourth generation and fifth generation. So here I want you to remember that the first generation will have FA in its name, and or it could have PHA. I'll just write it. It can have FA, PHA, and it can also end with IN. Okay, so coming on to the first one, which is cefadroxil. Second one, which is cefazolin. Then we have cephalexin, cephalothin. We have an exception here, which is cefaclor. Okay, now this has FA, FA, PHA, ends with IN. Now coming on to the third generation. For third generation, you need to remember that it will always end with INE. So what we have is cefixime, then we have cefotaxime, then we have ceftibuten. We have certain exceptions also, for example moxaractum. Now here in second generation we have an exception, which is cefuroxime. Okay, this is cefixime, cefactoxime. These are the exceptions. This is an exception in the second generation. Fourth generation will always end with PI. So we have cefpirome, cefpine. Just add cef in front. Okay, then coming on to the fifth generation, here what you will see is they'll have RO in their name, RO. So what it is ceftobiprol, ceftarolin. Now here I'll add one more, cefoxitin, the exception here. Okay, now how do you differentiate them? The first generation are very good against positive and moderately good towards gram negative, whereas the second generation is good against gram negative and moderate against gram positive. This is good against gram negative and weak against gram negative. This is good against gram negative and extended activity against gram positive. What we see is, as we go through the generations towards this direction, we see that their action toward against gram negative increases and the extent of action against the gram positive decreases. Okay, this is how you will remember cephalosporins and their classification.